Number 8. Life of a Gladiator. Some works of fiction have a tendency to glamorize the life of a Roman gladiator, but according to most historians, the reality was much more complicated. These combatants endured brutal training in gladiator schools and were often seen as more of a financial asset than human beings. They were socially marginalized and lived in constant fear of death. Most of them were slaves from conquered peoples, condemned to fight and die for the entertainment of Roman citizens. The strong were celebrated and enjoyed a number of perks, but earning a crowd's admiration meant slaughtering man and beast alike. Aside from armed combat against each other, they hunted exotic animals or fought as bestiarii against lions, bears, and other dangerous beasts. In keeping with Roman values, it was expected of a gladiator to show complete bravery, even in the face of certain death. By some estimates, the average gladiator died by the time they were 27, and few survived more than 10 contests in the arena. Number 7. Commodus's personality cult. Considered a megalomaniac by most historic sources, Emperor Commodus believed himself to be a gladiator and the reincarnation of a mythological hero. He would often enter the arena as a secutor, a type of gladiator armed with a short sword and heavy shield. He always won because his opponents understood what would happen to them if they didn't submit to their emperor. Commodus's gladiatorial pursuits were considered disgraceful and scandalous by Roman society. Whenever he entered the arena, the emperor charged the city of Rome a million sesterces, thus damaging the economy. His self-indulgent displays in the arena were described as horrific. Amputees were sometimes tied together for Commodus to bludgeon to death, while pretending they were giants. According to Cassio Dio, he once killed 100 lions in a single day. He also killed 3 elephants by himself, slaughtered a giraffe, and decapitated an ostrich. Naturally, a context was created so that Commodus would be safe while butchering the beasts. He also slayed his training partners, executed people out of sheer paranoia, and on one occasion had a Roman baths attendant thrown into an oven because the water was lukewarm. Number 6. Molten Gold Execution. In the year 90 BC, Roman consul Manius Aquilius was sent to Asia Minor to restore a previous ruler who'd been dethroned by Mithridates VI of Pontus, also known as Mithridates the Great. He's often remembered as one of Rome's most formidable adversaries. After successfully restoring the previous ruler, King Nicomedes, Manius Aquilius encouraged him to raid further into Pontic territories. This started the first Mithridatic War, in which several Greek cities led by Mithridates would rebel against Roman rule. Aquilius was captured as he tried to flee back to his homeland. He was delivered to Mithridates, who had him paraded on a donkey while forced to confess his alleged crimes against the peoples of Pergamon. Aquilius was hated by the locals mainly because his father, who once served as governor in the region, had imposed severe taxes. The Roman consul was ultimately executed in gruesome fashion by Mithridates. After he was done humiliating him, the king had his soldiers pour molten gold down his throat. This was done symbolically to represent the fatal consequences of his greed. Some sources claim that it was the same method of execution used against Marcus Licinius Crassus, who at one point was considered the richest man in Rome. Before we move on, official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. It's out of this world. Number 5. Abuse of the lower classes. In ancient Rome, status was everything. This meant that people of a higher social standing enjoyed a type of freedom that others didn't. Many took advantage of their privileged positions to inflict horrific abuse on the lower classes. Prostitution was legal, public, and widespread. However, prostitutes, either male or female, were considered infames, people who'd lost their legal and social status. Their bodies were largely considered public goods. Rape, therefore, could only be committed against a citizen in good standing. Slave represented the lowest class in society, and sexuality was the core feature of slavery in ancient Rome. Under Roman law, slaves were regarded as private property, so their masters were free to do with them as they wished. They were subjected to corporal punishment, torture, sexual exploitation, or summary execution, and no one would bat an eye. Fellow slaves could live together as husband and wife, but weren't allowed to legally marry. Any children they had would only add to their owner's wealth. Rome was an absolute patriarchy, and as one Italian classicist put it, the head of a household exercised a power outside any control of society and the state. Number 4. Condemnation to beasts. Damnatio ad bestias, or condemnation to beasts, was a type of capital punishment used in ancient Rome. It ultimately became part of gladiatorial combat, as gladiators were taught wild animal behavior and how to fight them in the arena. These animals included leopards, lions, bears, elephants, hyenas, wolves, and other dangerous creatures. Historians typically distinguish between damnatio ad bestias, in which the condemned were prepared for the fight, and objecia bestis, in which the condemned were defenseless. Between the 1st and 3rd century AD, this practice was reserved for runaway slaves, notorious criminals, and Christians. Nero had those who followed the Christian faith wrapped in animal skins and thrown to the dogs. The practice of feeding criminals to lions as punishment was first brought to ancient Rome by generals who'd fought in Africa during the 2nd century BC. Number 3. Cult of Cybele. In 204 BC, the Senate officially adopted Cybele as a state goddess. Cybele was worshipped as an earth deity and referred to as Magna Mother or Great Mother. Her consort was Attis, a god of vegetation, who in the legend went mad and cut off his genitals. This act of self-mutilation, as well as the god's death and resurrection, represented renewal during the seasonal change from winter to spring. For the priests of Cybele, known as the Galli, worship meant becoming eunuchs. Their self-castration was publicly performed during a ceremony on March the 24th, known as the Day of Blood. As part of the ceremony, the men would also wear women's clothes, heavy makeup, as well as their hair long and bleached. Because of this practice, some scholars have interpreted the priests of Cybele as being transgendered. The ban on castration was lifted during the reign of Claudius, but reinstated under Domitian. Number 2. Crucifixion. Crucifixion is best known from Christian tradition as the execution method which ended the earthly life of Jesus. Many churches and items of worship used the cross as a symbol. Crucifixion was an extremely painful form of capital punishment practice in ancient Rome. The brutality and humiliation associated with it was meant to deter people from committing crimes. It was heavily criticized by notable orators, such as Cicero, who called it most cruel and disgusting. Condemned criminals were often flogged and forced to carry the heavy crossbeam to the execution site. Once there, they would be stripped of their clothes and tied or nailed to the cross. If still alive while on the cross, the condemned would eventually succumb to asphyxiation or heart failure from the strain that their position put on their bodies. Number 1. Roman Killing Theater. Another disturbing aspect about life in ancient Rome is how a public execution was sometimes turned into a game or a twisted theater performance. One example was a popular play called Laureolus, about a bandit who is crucified. It wasn't uncommon for an actual prisoner to be nailed to the cross during the performance. Wild animals were then released upon him. According to another source, a man named Meniscus was dressed and made to act like Hercules before he was burned alive, mirroring the death of the mythological hero. According to Strabo, a Sicilian bandit named Celerus was placed on a wooden imitation of Mount Etna. As the prop mountain collapsed, he fell into a cage beneath it, where he was mauled to death by wild animals. In another sickening performance, a woman prisoner was forced to couple with a bull. This was based on the myth of Pasiphae, who mated with a bull, thus giving birth to the Minotaur. Thanks for watching. Would you rather spend a month as a soldier in an active war zone today, or a month as a gladiator in ancient Rome? Let us know in the comments section below.